absolutely essential. Play is essential for students to learn. And in school, we require our students to collaborate because collaboration has a huge effect size on learning. And if you can't play, you can't collaborate. So a playground is just as essential as books to an elementary school. And a safe playground is absolutely one of the most important things that I can guarantee a family and students as a principal.
Play creates the building blocks to society in a young age. It's where kids learn social skills. It's where they learn critical problem solving. It's where they learn how to get along with each other. It's where they learn crisis management. It all happens on a playground. And so these spaces that facilitate that type of socio and emotional learning within kids are vital to create the next generation of community members that know how to interact with each other and solve problems. That's all happens at play.
I think it's really important for kids to have safe places to play other than just their house and their yard to help build independence and autonomy and give them an opportunity to socialize and play with kids other than just their immediate neighbors or even friends who they would invite over to their house.
The right built environment can foster those skills at a greater level than anything before. You know, and it can be as fundamental as just like an open space in a field, or something as amazing as a play structure where kids can use their imagination and engage in active play that's not facilitated by anything else or anyone else but them and their peers.
So there are numerous studies that show after students come in from recess that their academic achievement increases. It's just an essential part also for developing their gross motor skills, building their endurance, and many things that lead to a healthy lifestyle happen on the playground.
Parks and playgrounds are very important for the North Side, West Side because we have a very high number of really people that are low income, generational poverty, so that means they've been in poverty for 30 years or more.
Because of the socioeconomic diversity of this neighborhood, free, open, accessible places to celebrate and be as a family and play as a child as a safe place is even more vital.
My older son is on the spectrum, and so for him, something that he really developed going to Lowell was learning a lot of social skills and how to interact with others. Seeing him be able to do that on the playground and really utilize those skills that his team had, you know, worked so hard with him to teach him those skills was really just, you know, like hits you in the heart.
The existing Westside Park playground was constructed in 1998. And it's a really unique structure in that it was built by the neighborhood, by a group of volunteers that lived here. They did all the fundraising, and they actually put in their blood, sweat, and tears to build this playground.
And what we're dealing with is an old playground. We really are.
So the life expectancy of this playground is about 20 years, and we've exceeded that. And it's a mostly wood structure, and so if you think about wood and Montana climate, it's not going to last forever, and it's starting to degrade, and so that's why it's in need of replacement.
We love Lowell Park, and I love the idea that there's going to be a new beautiful, wonderful park for my family to play in and for all of our friends.
So the new playground is going to consist of modern play equipment. The life expectancy is more like 30 years, and so it's a really good investment and a good value. And the new playground will have 5 different play zones. And so each zone is unique in the sense that it offers different types of play experiences for the kids. And so one of the playground zones is called Lowell Mountain. And so we're going to use rubberized safety surfacing to create topography in the playground. And just the topography itself actually creates kind of a play feature. It's a place for kids to run up and down and tumble down the hill. But on top of that, we're going to put a giant tower on top of the mountain, and we'll have a big slide that comes all the way down from the top down to the base of the mountain. So kids will get the sense that they're on top of the world and they can slide all the way down.
This neighborhood is really a neighborhood that uses parks. And so a lot of the kids in our neighborhood don't necessarily do camps or do a lot of other out-of-neighborhood activities. So this park is really an anchor always for our neighborhood and all the kids here.
The park will help students become better students. They'll have the opportunity to take a break from their studies and come have fun, rejuvenate, and go back to their classroom with a clear mind.
We helped build this playground when I was still in the school district. So I remember how exciting it was getting brand new play equipment. So I'm really excited for the kids now to have that experience.